welcome to another special episode of India Today, India Tomorrow, where we take you through a slice of history and life by cutting across generations. And today we are joined by a very special threesome. Please welcome Bengali royalty or Bengali cinematic royalty, Moon Sen and her daughters Raima and Riya Sen. Thank you very much for joining me on India Today, India Tomorrow.
Thank
Is that a right description, Bengali cinematic royalty?
In a way, but you know that Dad is the royalty and we're not. Dad and my mother, in two different ways.
Tell me how.
Well, their father really does come from three or four different royal houses. Mm-hmm. And my mother will be royalty.
Your mother will be royalty. And I'm going to start, I must start with your mother and their grandmother. Because her sort of larger than life presence, her legendary status hangs over this room, probably hangs over your lives. What was it like, first of all, growing up as the granddaughters of Suchitra Sen?
I think when we were growing up, I mean, we didn't really feel it that much. She had already not retired from the movies by then. Of course, then it was Moon Sen, because mummy was a sensation then, and mummy would come to pick us up from school, and the whole school would empty out just to take her autograph. So I think we felt it, while growing up, we felt mummy's star presence more. And then later, when we grew up, finished our college, then we realized how famous my grandmother was.
Yes.
Much later.
You have a smile on your face.
I forgot.
Almost not convinced about those days when your school would empty out to take your mother's autograph.
No, but that's a fact. But I've forgotten the question because I was listening to her answer.
The question is, what was it like being the granddaughter of Suchitra Sen?
Well, obviously, it was great. And it still is very great. And was very, very glad that we're Suchitra Sen's granddaughters. And we're always going to feel it. But she's right, when we were growing up, it was mostly my mom's influence. And everywhere we went, it was like Moon Sen's daughter, Moon Sen's daughter, more than Suchitra Sen's granddaughter.
But I must come to Suchitra Sen, because what was it like growing up as Suchitra Sen's daughter?
As it must have been for you, growing up as your father's son. Wonderful, it opens so many doors.
You know, my father's favorite actor was Suchitra Sen, and I watched Andhi 6 times. So I'm just wondering, in the Kolkata cinematic environment where you grew up, in Kolkata itself, in the days of her sort of the height of her success, were you in awe? Were you completely sort of submissive to the aura of Suchitra Sen?
You know, this is very personal, Rajdeep, but I grew up as a film star's daughter. Even though she was the most wonderful mother, she would ring up 3 times a day from work to find out if I'd had my lunch, my tea, or whatever, my tuition masters had arrived or not. But she was always a very big star. We went shopping, we went out for shootings. I was always looking after her, protecting her. So it was a very funny feeling to see.
You were protective of your mother.
Protected. Yes. We were doing Andhi in Kashmir in a song, and they mobbed her. And for some reason, she, bad temper, but you can't show it in a crowd. She came away, they were trying to manhandle her. And I went to rescue her. I picked up her slipper, which she threw at this man, which came me instead. And I landed up beating up Raj Sippy, who is the director of the film. But I mean, there was a great deal of, you know, I have to protect this lady from all these wicked
people. You threw
people.
A shoe?
She threw a shoe.
She threw a shoe?
Well, that bad temper has, you know, gone down the line.
So this, are you all bad-tempered Sens? These beautiful Sens are bad-tempered women?
Behind the beautiful mask. Comes,
so this is the mask, is
it's
it?
It's hereditary, so yeah, I guess.
What's the big difference between mum and grandmum? Well, is there a big difference between Moon Sen and Suchitra Sen?
She's more bad-tempered than my grandma.
No.
She's more bad-tempered.
That's my opinion.
I think both the tempers are the same.
So were you also intimidated by your mother at some stage?
When we were young, we were very frightened of mummy.
We're but still very frightened of mummy.
And the father also says he's frightened of mummy.
Yes.
I mean, where do I go?
We're still frightened.
What is it about Moon Sen? Why are you such a frightening sort of presence in people's lives? Are you the domineering woman?
Actually, Rajdeep, I don't know. Maybe your wife will understand, or the women and who are working will understand. But I have very little time. I'm traveling, I'm working. So if something goes wrong, it's cut, 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 cut. Why did you do this? Don't do this. And so they get traumatized and think, oh God, bad temper again. But it's not. I don't have the time to sit down and explain like most mothers.
Are you trying to conform?
My mother was very bad tempered. I grew up with that 10 times more than me.
Are you trying to conform to the stereotype of the mercurial Bengali tigress? You know, there is that stereotype has been created.
She just
puts men on the defensive.
She's naturally like that.
You're naturally like that.
What can I say?
She's the epitome.
She has asked my father that question actually more than anyone else.
But over the years, has she mellowed down or not?
Yes.
Not
I've stopped working.
At all.
I have mellowed down.
You've mellowed down. Yes, you haven't stopped working. You're a member of parliament now. I should have introduced you not just as cinematic royalty, but as a member of parliament who defeated a 9-time MP in Basudev Acharya in Bakura. That couldn't have been easy.
Without knowing it.
Without quite knowing it.
I didn't know who Basudev Acharya was. When I found out, I said, well, I'm not going to say anything nasty about him. And to his credit, he never said anything nasty about me. But I'm a film star like them. We go out into crowds of 22, 25,000 and everybody loves you. So there was no question in my mind of losing. Of course, people were going to come and the rat is here. And of course, people were going to come here and, you know, vote for me. And I was going to win against whoever it was.
You know, I'll come back to you and your political career in a moment, but let's talk about cinema. Do you believe cinema is in the blood? Do you believe it's in your bloodstream? Was this something that you always wanted to do?
I think
we had no choice.
That's different. Did you have no choice to become?
I'm not allowed to talk. Was it pouncing at me if I say anything?
No, come on.
Okay, let them.
No, Riya, just a minute. Did your mum tell you you have to become
No, it's just that when we were growing up, everywhere we went with my mom and my dad, people were like, oh my God, she's going to grow up and become an actress. She's going to grow up and become a star. She's going to grow up and become an actress. So it was just like automatically like imbibed in us that we were going to be actresses. And so I guess. And then we started getting offers at a very young age, and so we.
You were 9th standard, I believe, when you got an offer.
Yeah, I did my first film with my mother when I was 5 years old. Then I did my second film when I was 13. Then I started properly acting when I was in class 9.
Raima,
I always wanted to be an actress. I think when we were young, we used to play actress. And mom used to go off to work.
We also played all her makeup,
hair dryers and everything every day.
Yeah, we'd wear
and
her big wigs.
And when we'd go to the set and like watch her acting, I'd always want to be that girl that she was playing the mother to. So I'd go and dress. I'd dress up like that little girl and every day. So I think I've always wanted to be an actor and. I joined much later. I joined after college and everything.
College. You joined when you were very young, and you actually joined when you were rather old.
After motherhood and marriage, you didn't want to join. Still, I never wanted to join. A year of Bengali films, started crying when hubby said, a year later, try the Hindi films. I said, no, I don't want to go anywhere, but I went. And it was a battle for me.
And you were in your 30s when you
was very close to my 30s.
Very close to your 30s.
And a mother of two, which is unforgivable by Hindi standards, film standards. Not in Bengal, I don't think.
And you did a film, Andar Bahar, with Jackie Shroff and Anil Kapoor. And you were dressed in a bikini.
Not through the film.
In one sequence. In one sequence, which suddenly had you on every film magazine.
You had a great figure, no doubt about it.
Because I was Googling and the first thing was there, Bohemian girl, bold and daring. I mean,
from
it was
Jadavpur, what else can you expect?
From Jadavpur University, bold and daring. I mean, was that something you were comfortable with? Was that something which became almost a victim of a stereotype?
You know, Rajdeep, I swam. When you swim, only in Bangladesh, when you do a Bengali film and you're in a swimming pool, are you expected to wear jeans, which I wore. But in India, we wear a swimsuit. So I wore a swimsuit for a swimming pool scene. But it was quite sensational because it was cut out at the sides. I had a great body and I thought, oh, I will be a lesson to married mothers because I have no stretch marks. You have no experience, but some mummies have terrible tummies.
We shall not even go down that route. But look, at the end of the day, were you a victim in a sense of a stereotype? Because your mother, on the other hand, Suchitra Sen was seen in a very different guise, even in Hindi cinema, whether it's in a Devdas, whether it's in a Mamta, whether it's in an Andhi. You know, she was this almost remote, inaccessible figure. And there you were performing these roles, which, as I said, are described as bold for their times. In the 80s, a bikini was still not necessarily seen as something that has that an actress should do. It should be left for the vamp.
Or the hero.
That's right.
But you never saw Sharmila Tagore in an evening in Paris?
That's right.
My God, she was stunning. So I think we just had to do it and get the public used to it. They're all swimming now.
It wasn't part of you trying to differentiate yourself from your mother?
No, not at all, because I'd done Bengali films for a year before that. Mm-hmm. There were no swimsuits there.
And the two of you, particularly you, again on Google, is described as bold. You know, there was that Dabu Ratnani calendar where you were, you know, dressed up in a manner that I believe
bold.
Even your mother had a problem with.
Mother has a problem just looking
my
at
my mother has a
screen,
problem with
both.
Me even right now, I'm sure.
You have a problem with, you dressed up the way you wanted, but you had a problem when apparently
yes.
She
was
she
always
did a,
very confused. Like I was told to wear a mini skirt and then I would think, oh my God, my mom will kill me. And then the next thing I'm like wearing something else and then I'm like showing my midriff and I'm like, oh my God, but my mother's going to kill me. So I was so confused. And then in the middle of that confusion, I was also tagged as this.
Were you happy with the tag of a young sex symbol, this youth icon, you know, in modeling, doing a calendar as a calendar girl?
I wasn't unhappy about it, but I didn't understand why just me. Because there were people who were like way bolder and doing many other things. But if I wore a miniskirt, it was a big deal. If I wore a swimsuit, it was a big deal. But if everyone else did it, it was just very normal.
And Raima, you fall somewhere in between the two stools, is it? I mean, did you sort of,
yes.
I mean, did you try and sort of consciously create an image for yourself? In your case, you know, with Chokher Bali, for example.
I think I just got lucky.
You got lucky. Chokher Bali, yeah. Rituparno Ghosh, a more,
yes.
the sort of image of a more serious actor, more in your grandmother's.
Yes, but
mode.
When you ask my mother who's naughtier, I'm the naughtier one. But I just got lucky with my, you know, with these kind of roles and, so I've maintained that image.
So when you say naughtier, you mean you're actually bolder in real life than she is?
Yes.
In a sense. Yes?
Yes.
Silence.
Yes, she is. Yeah.
But do you believe
wicked.
That the Hindi film industry or the Bengali cinema, I'm presuming, is very different to Hindi cinema? And you do a lot of Bengali cinema. And the general impression is Bengali cinema is more serious. The directors are looking to actually cast their heroines in specific roles.
I think because she looks more serious.
She has the look that makes her look more serious.
Yeah.
But is there a distinction between...
When I have done this...
Really bad for her.
Sorry?
There have been scenes when I have been like this, looking at Raima's films. So what? When it comes to being bored... Mirch, bhule gaya cha?
Oh, yes.
Father's most hated film of hers, mm-hmm. where she's done these natural love scenes and she's acted so beautifully. And he said, I hated the film. I said, but why? He said, all those love scenes, I've got over it now. I just turn away when they're kissing.
Dreadful. I think I was one of the first in Bengali cinema to do my first kissing scene
mm-hmm.
for a song with Porum. Yeah, and so in Bengal, yes, I think I started that trend. Not too many actors kiss on screen.
But were you all both
now.
Very comfortable with your sexuality, and are you still very comfortable with that?
Yeah, I am.
Yes.
No, but you said that you had a problem at times,
no,
the way people sort of
I just didn't
defined you.
I never made a conscious, you know, attempt to like create a certain image. It just, the media created it for me.
But I'm just wondering,
yes.
how did poor old hubby, your husband, good royalty, original royalty,
oh,
deal with three
it.
Women?
He
because
loves
in
it.
His family, mm-hmm. he has women who my mother-in-law flew a plane, obviously not in a sari, she was in trousers. Mashima Gayatri Devi swam, so she must have worn a swimsuit. And they've all been so glamorous and free and westernized. And yet, very Indian in their beliefs and values and customs.
Yeah,
so he's grown up in that, and he's not.
That's right. Your husband's aunt is Gayatri Devi for those of Jaipur. For those who don't know, and I'm just wondering whether that's a bit of you as well. That there is this outward image of the bohemian girl, but inwardly, deeply conservative, middle-class Bengali woman.
My mother. Even
and
she was terribly sophisticated.
Were you also?
I thought she was describing me. Sorry.
No, I'm trying to describe you. I'm trying to describe.
Is that how you are? Yes.
So this is a mask that you wear for the world.
I wear different masks all the time, and a lot of people who know me well or don't know me will say, "Moon, we know you just put on this, you know, bubbly little bimbit act." And
bubbly little
really,
bimbit act.
Yeah. Which is going down the generations. You know.
she doesn't quite again agree, right, Riya?
But
the
it's
bubbly,
the easiest,
bimbit act.
It's the easiest thing to do because you don't want to talk to everybody who wants to talk to you. You don't want to be judged by everybody. I have been judged and given an image. She has been judged, given an image. So in the end, you just sit back and, you know, smile through it all.
Who do you want? Who is your sort of, do you have a role model as young actors? Have you had a role model, someone whom you wanted to emulate? Was it your mother, your grandmother, or was there someone else out there who you said, that's the kind of person I'd like to be or act like or live a life like?
No, not really. I mean, I think they're all great women and there are lots of great people out there. But I think it's very difficult to try and be like someone else. I think you should learn to be comfortable in your own skin.
Interesting. Raima?
I've always lived the way I wanted to live. No one I've like fancied or copied or wanted to be like.
You know, people don't know the other side of Moon Moon Sen because you, among other things that you did what? A course in graphics. You taught English in
Google.
A school.
Google?
I've done Google. I've done my Googling. But that's, you know, that's it.
Yes,
that's a very unusual life
very
for a star.
Baliganj Government High School, I taught. I did all India radio programs. That was the beginning. Mm-hmm. I've done reviews for Anand Bajar. Not Anand Bajar, Amrita Bajar. Mm-hmm. With film reviews. I've always been very interested in films. Not wanting to be an actress, but maybe a director. I've taught, done all kinds of things, and I think one should. And I'm very happy because she's doing a lot of yoga nowadays and Ayurveda. And Raima, of course, will not do anything but act. I mean, I prize education the highest thing in the life. And I think they're both educating themselves through their hobbies now, like I have. I'm still learning.
Have you sort of seen cinema as your education? That's where you've learned everything about life.
I think for me it's practical experience because I'm working a lot and so I get to learn, I get to work with a lot of good directors and so for me I just learn while I'm on the...
But what's the big difference between doing Bengali cinema and doing Hindi cinema?
Nothing really. I think it's just the language and the... nothing really.
Has language been a barrier for the two of you, learning Hindi?
A little bit, yes.
I mean, as good old Bengalis from Kolkata, learning Hindi, was that a big barrier for you all?
Yes.
So you had to play a certain kind of role was offered as a result to you, a more anglicized role as a result.
I just played a lawyer in a Hindi film, so I had to learn the dialogues. I learned my dialogues like a parrot, you know. But yeah, it's a bit of... it's a bit stressful.
Stressful? Learning Hindi?
Yes, yes. I never really, like... I mean, I never really studied the language, so it was difficult. But then when I went and did Bengali films, it was very difficult for me to speak in Bengali too because I was so busy trying to do Hindi films. But I've just completed a film which is like in English and Bengali and Hindi. But then I guess you just have to like learn the art of just like learning it by heart and saying it.
What do you all think in? Do you all think in English? Is English the first language? So how did you make that transition then to Bengali and Hindi? I'm presuming Suchitra Sen was different in that sense.
Very different.
Right? She was very much rooted in this Bengali soil culture.
You know, she was a different kind of an actress. She did Bengali films, she did a few Hindi and didn't stray from Bengal. Mm. I strayed. I did films in 22 languages. So I was dubbed all over. I've worked with Ravi Chandran and...
Yeah, you won a Best Supporting Actor for a Telugu film once.
No, it wasn't Supporting Actor. It was a Nandi Award.
Okay, it was a Nandi Award. So yes, it's an actor award.
And I was working with Suhasini. So that was really a big thing. But I look at them when they're working. I used to go before when they were working, not anymore. And I'm amazed at the way they pick up languages. You either have an art of doing it or you don't. I just couldn't do it.
But I'm
so
just
dubbed all over.
But I'm just wondering, one of the reasons why Suchitra Sen had a certain mystique about her was that she was seen as the recluse. She even refused the Dada Saheb Phalke Award
and many
because
others.
She didn't want to be seen in public. And the three of you are all over the place. There are, I won't go down that route. There are Instagrams of you and all kinds of things on social media.
But there was no social media active.
Your grandmother would have stayed away from social media.
Yes, she would have. Actually.
You know, she never had mobile phones. We had mobile phones. Today, the kids have mobile phones in school, and we didn't have mobile phones. So, like, the times are different. The movies were different.
Social media.
The kind of like, everything was so
but
different.
She was a recluse, really, right? Wasn't she a recluse?
It's impossible to be a recluse today.
Journalists, right? So when my mother, when I entered the films and people started coming over and she accepted it, 3 months she didn't talk to me. She said, journalists, stay in the veranda. We had a kind of sit out in the veranda.
She refused to allow the journalists in the house.
She told me they don't. For her, they never came to the house.
Why? What was it?
Talk to her.
What was it?
Because
there was only what made her a recluse?
There was only a kind of yellow journalism or a political, reasonable journalism. But in our time, we have so many kinds in between. For me, it's a great honor to be sitting here with you today. At the same time, I've had calls from other channels and I've said, no, I'm not available. I won't do it.
No, but why would your... What change do you think between Suchitra Sen's generation to the generation of Riya Raima and in between
and
as you are?
Social media, for sure.
Social media.
Yes.
Yeah.
I think with social
media,
you can like represent yourself instead of having 10,000 other people tag you in a certain way and brand you. You can brand yourself, you can represent yourself, and you can speak for yourself. So I think
do
it's
you
amazing.
Enjoy social media? I thought it's
I
a double-edged sword.
I
mean, when,
I
you,
think,
when you're on social
it.
Media, there will be people out there to get you at the same time.
Yes.
I mean,
yes,
whenever there were, you know, every time there's a sort of revealing photograph of Riya Sen, you'll have lots of people gunning for you. You're comfortable with that?
True.
Yes, but you know, usually like they will only put up like the bad pictures of you. In your social media, you can put up your best pictures and you can put your best foot forward and you can be yourself on your own social media.
Mm-hmm.
So I think
there's much more competition now. There's many, like there are many more actors, and I think you just have to be out there. I think it was different then.
Would Suchitra Sen have been on Instagram? Would she be have been on Twitter?
Don't
would she have been
so.
Sharing her thoughts with her friends on Facebook?
She probably
no,
have someone
never,
to
no,
never.
No,
never.
Never.
No way.
No.
No way would she have strayed straight into this world of social media.
See, when we say recluse, she did have a few friends and family.
Mm-hmm.
But she wasn't open to people she didn't know. I have had to be a little bit. They are.
Okay. Let me take a break on that point, because when we return, I'm going to turn to your politics. And I'm also going to look at a statement that I saw, that your girls are very high maintenance. Exactly, they are. Moon Sen and her daughters, Riya and Raima. Let's talk about politics for a moment, because your words, not mine. Why did a bimbet suddenly decide to get into politics with the Trinamool Congress all the way there in Bakura in 2014 and take on someone like Basudev Acharya, who you confessed you didn't even know, even though he's an 8 or 9-time MP of the CPM?
Nine times.
And you didn't know that he was who he was, and yet you went all the way in Bakura and won the election. What was that? Mamata Banerjee's appeal that drove you into politics? What took you into politics? Or just boredom? I need to try something new.
She announced my name without asking me. And there was no going back. Because she had been a very wonderful person when my mother had passed away. She had done everything more than the call of duty and more than a chief minister would. And she just stood by me. So when she announced my name, I didn't know what it was going to entail. And I just turned around to my husband, who has always guided me. And I said, now what do I do? He says, you can't let her down. You just
so
do it and I will help you.
So you didn't have a sense of duty?
No.
Because I'm just wondering how you fit
duty.
Into today's politics.
At that
politics.
Time, she was coming in and she was like a family member. How do I fit into the politics of today? I don't know, but I think it's very easy. You go out to your constituency, 4 hours away, you talk to the people, you travel, mine is, each place is 1 hour, 2 hours, 3 hours away, you talk to them and they'll tell you what they want, because for 35 years nobody gave them nothing. So they'll tell you they want water, they'll tell you they want a house, they'll tell you I gave them cemeteries, they want little roads to go to the bigger town to cross over. And that is easy to do with the federal money that you were given.
So was this a wake-up call for you from the world which you'd lived in? Suddenly you were out there in the back lanes of Bakura?
No. I had done folk plays, Jatra, so I had met people from the villages. But if you're Calcutta, you've worked with Mother Teresa, you've, you know, done little bits and pieces that you're happy to do at a certain age, and then you get busy with a professional, commercial world, so it was kind of going back to that.
So while she was going out in Bakura and campaigning as a politician, did you A, approve, and did you join her? Were you sort of part of the campaign?
We've been a part all the time. Every time she goes, I think we're there.
We killed it. We were all over the place. We campaigned left, right and center.
So but we always Vasudev Acharya, unlike her.
Well, we found out.
We found out. And what was the best experience of campaigning?
And then we went all out.
What was the best experience of campaigning?
Never seen so many people.
And you were sort of just looking over them as the sort of...
My hands almost fell off.
Yes.
Your hands fell off doing this and this?
We're doing road shows.
And you're Bengali?
A lot.
And you're Bengali?
My Bengali is fine. They understand it. Don't forget we speak so many dialects. So they were happy to see somebody who'd left her husband and sometimes her children and come down to be with them. And then when they came, it was, you know, icing on the cake.
So Bengali, public rally in Bengali to a crowd of 40,000.
Yes.
Bakura, done, no problem?
No problem. I've done four plays.
Road shows.
And the best advice I gave them was, don't drink too much water.
Don't drink water at all, she said.
Why?
I told you each place is 2 hours away or an hour away.
No, because there's a lack of water in Bakura.
And bathrooms.
Sorry, are you part of the Swachh Bharat program of the Prime Minister ensuring that there will be bathrooms in Bakura?
No, if they don't have homes, there's no point giving them toilets.
So they need homes?
They have some. They keep the cows in them. And in the extreme cold, they live in them. So I'm talking about the rural areas, really deep interiors.
Is she really happy being in politics? She's not going to give me an honest answer, so you're going to have to give
Wasn't
it
that
me.
Honest?
Are you happy with being in politics?
I'm in the middle of a world I don't understand.
That's what
and
I want to
I think
know.
I'm doing a great job because I've singled it out to just, it's helping people. And in the film industry, you're always helping the makeup man's daughter who has to buy textbooks. Or you're always helping people out. So it's a continuation.
So it's a form of
that.
Social work, because I'm just wondering.
It is social work.
When you're in parliament surrounded by all those noisy MPs, you tell yourself where
well,
I
was
got
also
myself
part of,
stuck.
I was also part of the noisy MPs. I may not approve of it, but that's what you politicians do.
Do you shout and scream in Parliament?
I don't shout and scream in Parliament.
Is she a natural politician, you think?
I think she's a people's person. Mm-hmm. So whether she likes to be a politician or not, I think she's in the right profession.
She's in the right profession.
Yes. At last.
At last you've got a sort of certificate, a character certificate from your daughter. At least one daughter.
It's
Raima?
A big thing.
She's less bad tempered now. We have to deal with other people, so we are like
she helps people a lot. It's like she's got this natural flair for it. So
yeah, I can imagine Mamta's bad temper and your bad temper.
No, but she is where she is today because she helped people out.
Sure. It's just that politics is a very different world. What's been the biggest learning for you in politics over these last 4 years? Is there something that has sort of really, in a way, affected you as a person from that world of cinema which you came from, the sort of elite confines of, comfortable confines of South Kolkata? What is the biggest learning there?
You know, it's such a difficult question to answer, Rajdeep. It's a mean question to answer. Mm-hmm. I mean, to a question to ask me, because it would entail a lot of thinking. But I think the only satisfying thing is you can help people. You can't help them one-to-one. I didn't know what Panyo Jol was when my Bengali is very weak. When I went to Bakura, there would be very poor people stopping my car. They wear one, you know, dhoti a year or something. So I turned around to this guy and I said, what is Panyo Jol? They're all asking for Panyo Jol. And they said, it's drinking water. Forget about bathing, because they all bathe in those little ponds. So it's not that it was foreign to me, but I just didn't know how poor this country is. And you don't want me to go on and say more about that.
We
That's
won't
it.
Go down that road and
no,
say more
no.
about poverty in Bengal and the
Everywhere.
Rest of the country. But I'm asking,
in Bangalore.
Would the two of you join politics ever? Suppose Mamata Banerjee came tomorrow to you, Riya, and said, Riya, I need a young face for the Trinamool Congress. What would you tell her?
I don't know.
You'd just be silent.
I'm not sure.
You're not sure, right?
Maybe much later.
Would you ever consider
Well, I've told my mother I wouldn't mind, but I don't know what my mother has in mind. I don't know whether she'd approve or not.
Yeah, because you have all these political dynasties emerging, so you can always pass Bakura off to your daughters one day.
No, I think she's too young. I don't think she'd be able to handle the people around her. You know, the middle people?
Mm-hmm.
That's very difficult to be with. And I don't, I know, I think she'd get very hurt. She's very sensitive.
she wouldn't be able to do it.
So you're saying sensitive people should stay away from politics?
She's too sensitive and too sheltered.
Too sensitive, too sheltered. Now you're being judgmental about
by
them because
father.
I also read a quote
by
on Google. I read a quote on Google saying, I have two very high maintenance girls. If they have to get married, as they should, the person better be a very rich man.
It's
right?
True. It's true.
Is that true that you'll have very high maintenance? You're already married now, and you're presumably your husband is having a tough time looking after you.
He is. Yes, he is.
Now, the good thing is they're both working girls and they earn and they buy their little Jimmy Choo shoes.
We're very independent.
And things.
We're high maintenance because we're spoiled by our parents.
Mm-hmm. Very
independent. So if I trouble him, it's not because of other reasons. It's because, you know, the little tantrums here and there. That's about it.
No, but in a sense, you know, that's a good word. You're like independent professional women and you've always been that through your modeling and film career. Is that a sense that, you know, is that how you see yourself, your self-image as powerful women? And that's perhaps why even prospective men get intimidated at the idea of perhaps
that's why I'm still single.
Meeting you. That's why you're single, is it? Or but is work something that drives you, Raima?
Yes.
Because you do a lot of work in Hindi and Bengali cinema now, and you've had the good fortune of working with some very fine directors, both in Hindi and Bengali
yes.
cinema.
Yes, so I've been working ever since I've been 18. It's been a long time, and I'm working a lot. I mean, I think that's what keeps me going. My parents always like, take a holiday. Why do you work so much? And don't sign this film, you know, go travel. But then I'm constantly, I think,
they decide which films you should sign? Who decides which film? When you want to sign a film today, can you choose or would you just say, or do you have that option of saying no to a particular film?
No, I choose the best of what I get. I don't do everything, but I choose. If I get five films, I'll choose the best. I'll probably choose two.
Is it a regret that perhaps you don't get enough offers in Hindi cinema? You'd rather do more because it gives you a national image? Or are you just happy now that you're doing what you are in Bengali cinema in particular?
I'm very happy in Bengal, I think. But yeah, of course I'd like to do more Hindi cinema. I am doing some this year.
So are you Calcutta girls? Are you Mumbai girls? Are you
Calcutta
just
girls.
Cosmopolitan Indian girls? You live in Mumbai
yes.
with your dogs most of the
yes,
time,
yes.
who are very precious
very
to you, I'm told, Riya.
Yes.
So I mean, is there a sense of liberation that you get being away from Calcutta, or is Calcutta still home?
No, I love being in Bombay. I've been there since forever. Mm-hmm. I think for the last 18 years. But when I come back to Calcutta, there's nothing like it. I love Calcutta. It is the city of joy.
It is the city of joy?
Yes. All my friends are here. My family's here. I feel like the sense of home. But I love Bombay too. It's home for me too.
Calcutta, Mumbai or Delhi? You have a little house now in South Avenue.
And Goa.
Yes.
And
yes.
Goa also.
Yes.
So what's home for you?
Calcutta always was. But after my mother's passed away, it's almost 4 years, I'm rootless. I can just go off anywhere.
What is it about Calcutta, particularly in the Calcutta that you grew up in,
well,
that makes it
exist.
So special? I've met a number of Kolkatans, particularly who grew up in the city in the 60s and 70s, who tell me there is no place like Calcutta.
No, but it doesn't exist. What it used to be, it's the fair, the art fairs and the art exhibitions and the music, you know, the all night long musical stories. That doesn't exist. It's not the same.
Are you also deep down inside the Kolkata girl?
I love Calcutta, yes. So if when I'm in Bombay and I'm working, then I keep
Kolkata.
Wanting to come back. So I am fully Kolkata.
What is it about Bengal that you think, you know, makes Bengali or Bengal so special? What is it about Bengal that holds you?
In Calcutta, the difference for me would be symbolized by the fact that you go to a wedding, mm-hmm. and you take a bunch of Rajanigandha and a book. That's your gift to the bride and the bridegroom. That is Kolkata, and that's disappearing very fast. Of course, you can't give them a phone or a laptop or anything, but that was Calcutta. There was a sweetness, there was an intellectual sweetness. The coffee shop, and you know, you remember somebody you met 30 years ago, was really very famous, and all the talk about them. But it's not like that anymore.
What about Tollywood itself? I mean, your grandmother was in the sort of glorious period, in a way, of Tollywood. Satyajit Ray, Uttam Kumar, great names, Soumitra Chatterjee. I mean, from that era to today's era, is there a huge difference? Huge. Is it also now sort of, you know, everyone, the era of the really big stars has been replaced by everyone in this new fast food culture almost of cinema?
We can't get that back ever again. But I think Bengalis still live in that, you know, era.
Yes, every young filmmakers.
Very nostalgic, and they still live there and live in that era.
So do you have people perhaps from your grandmother's era who see you on a shoot or see your film and say, you know, that was good, but not quite Suchitra
said. I got that a lot earlier before Chokhir Bali, in fact. People would always say that to me when they'd come out of watching a film of mine, and I'd be like taken aback because it was probably my third or fourth film. But now I think they like come up to me, old ladies and men, and they're like, oh, you're Suchitra Sen's granddaughter, can we hold your hand? You know, and then they just want to, like, for my grandmother. So they just love her.
Because someone, you know, you do look a little bit.
Oh,
she does. She does look a little bit like your mother, doesn't she?
A lot like my mother.
And Riya?
Like her father. They both let me down.
They both let you down.
They don't look like me.
They don't look like you, and you don't look.
But I know whose father.
Well, did you have an inferiority complex in that sense over years? That there was the beautiful Greta Garbo-esque like Suchitra Sen, and there I am, Moon Sen, having to put out a bikini in Andar Bahar to be attractive.
I was already working here. And it wasn't in a bikini. It was a kind of a gharibo, yes, with a, you know, ghungat on and things like that.
But your mother's beauty, was that something that sort of was always spoken about?
She's amazing. Very few people have had to grow up with the kind of beauty that I have seen. But then again, I've seen it on my husband's side also. And I've met many international beauties. So you have to be nice inside too.
Yeah. So that's right. You know, what is your definition of beauty, ladies? How do you define what is beauty for you? Priya, come on.
I'm choking right now.
You're choking right now. Raima, what is beauty for you? How would you define a beautiful person?
Well, I have a family filled with beautiful women, but I think, I mean, it sounds very cliche, but you have to be a beautiful person. I mean, it doesn't matter.
Moon, what was it about hubby that attracted you all those years ago to him?
You know, it's cliched, like she says. He's like you. He's old world. He is so beautifully mannered, and he has the greatest sense of humor. And he has given me freedom. Freedom to go out and work, like he's given to the girls, and guidance. So,
was he completely comfortable also with your decision then to enter politics as well? Has he been comfortable with all the life decisions that you made?
Well,
if
maybe,
he ever saw you,
maybe not in a all. Film, maybe not all.
If he saw you in a film magazine and there was a gossip item about Moon Sen and someone, how
must,
would he react?
It must have hurt him. It must have hurt him. But he's a man, so he's taken it in his stride.
He never sort of raised it. There were no flashes of anger.
We don't have unpleasantness. I get angry if he has a couple of extra drinks or something. This is bad for his health. But we leave each other alone.
Okay, let me ask you all.
Great companions.
Very great companions. So you think companionship comes before love?
No, love. We were terribly in love. I've been in love with him since I was class 8. It didn't stop me from having other boyfriends. But I've been in love with him, and he's the only one I wanted to marry. So that love goes on to companionship.
What do you all do when you all are not surrounded by this world of stardom and cinema? How do you sort of chill in life? How do you relax? What's your idea of a relaxed weekend, for example?
Together.
Together or on your own?
On my own, I'm always traveling. I love to travel. I've always been like a fan of traveling. I'm doing a lot of yoga courses right now. I've just done like a teacher training in like yoga. Mm-hmm. And I'm going to do aerial yoga teacher training now in Bali. Also, like, you know, helps me to travel and like.
Prime Minister Modi could well have you as his brand ambassador for Yoga Day next time, Riya.
Yeah,
that's an option.
Maybe
or Ramdev. Ramdev, maybe. It's a
maybe not.
Well, what is it about yoga that makes you feel so good about it?
I don't know. I just think like yoga makes you look the way you want to look. It makes you feel better mentally, and it's just like it's like an overall thing, not just like your physical development, also for your mental. It's an overall. It transforms your life.
She's also good at it.
I don't do all of that. I just like. I have a lot of friends who are not from the industry, so I chill out with them, and I.
for a normal weekend, I'd probably just go swim or watch Netflix all day, binge watch and
do you think it's easier to have friends outside the film industry than have those people who you work with all the time?
Yeah, the conversation is completely different. I can let my hair down. I don't have to watch my back all the time, and I can just be. So I prefer.
No, we have a lot of young actors and actresses coming over, and sometimes there is a cultural difference, but. You know, it's okay if they're the same profession, whatever. But I think what we missed out is, as a family, we all enjoy good food. Yeah. So it's lunches out, and we love animals, dogs. So that's a large part of.
So what's the food? Is it kosha mangsho with mishti and chindi mash, or is it a good steak?
Tripura chakui.
It's everything.
Bhutanese aloo, yes. Thai food. She did a course.
She cooks
it's
very well.
Everything.
They make me cook for them and they're doing nothing.
So she makes, she's the cook in the family.
No, yeah. Hubby is.
Hubby is the cook.
Meaning he teaches his cooks and recipe books like that from there to there. And she has inherited
it. She's got his knack of cooking. So she
and do you cook at all?
No, but she makes tea.
Mommy, you. I've got everything from mommy.
All the bad things.
All the
right.
Bad things.
Thanks a lot. Thanks a lot.
You made your hubby cook for you all these years.
Well, he orders the dinner. You know, if I come home from work and I say, what's for dinner? He says, this is not a 5-star hotel. But I can't order what I like because no one else will eat it. I mean, he won't. It's boiled food. They like boiled food too. But
how do you relax? How does Moon Sen get away from Bakura and cinema and all
shopping.
Shopping.
Every day. She's a shopaholic.
And you call your poor daughters high maintenance.
Exactly. But you see, I buy things for the house or I buy a small plastic little spoon and that will make me happy. I'm not buying clothes so I don't feel guilty.
But I believe you sort of trained a bit under Jamini Roy when it came to painting. So you must be obviously having that a love for the arts. I'm told you have a wonderful collection of paintings.
Yes, some which got burnt in Bombay when my flat burned down. But I also knew Puritosh Sen well, and you know a lot of artists, and that helps you keep your interests alive.
So
many of them have gone.
So shopping is your way of relaxing,
shopping,
buying art or buying little
Netflix,
artifacts.
Netflix.
Her new obsession.
It's just lying in bed and watching
all
Netflix.
Day.
You have a favorite cereal?
Not right now. I've seen all the good historical ones. I watch rubbish on crimes and things
like that. So would you like to do a Netflix show? Do you see yourself playing, say, Indira Gandhi tomorrow, Mamata Banerjee, for example?
Favorite director, Anjun Dutt. And I would like to work with him and only him while I'm alive.
She should play herself,
like
the kind of show.
I do.
She should play herself in a show.
But he gives her those roles.
Life with Moon Moon Sen.
But he
is directed by Anjun Dutt.
He's worked with both my girls also.
Your favorite director. Do you have a favorite filmmaker? Someone whom you enjoyed really working with?
Well, I work a lot in Bengal with Kaushik Ganguly. So I enjoy working with him and now his wife. Oh, I think my best film has been No Kudubi with Rituparna Ghosh. So, yeah.
What was it like working with Rituparna?
He's special.
He was lovely.
He's taught us, I think, a lot of things
clearly
that no one could teach us.
Yeah.
Was he kind, gentle? Would he sort of take you scene by scene
very
through
funny.
A film?
He'd teach you everything you need to know. I think he can even make a tree act. He was that good. And he was that knowledgeable.
Very
and he was
creative,
that
very intelligent. Very great sense of humor.
You know, they were very dear friends, Ritu. This was his daughter, that was his friend. And one day he rang me up in distress. He says, Moon Moon, please tell her I'm a world famous director. I've won so many awards. She's fighting with me. She won't listen to me.
You weren't listening to Rituparna Ghosh?
He could not believe it, but it was so much fun. He didn't know what to do.
Okay, I'm going to ask you then in conclusion. Is there a role that you'd still like to do?
Yes.
What is that role?
Sister Nevedita.
You'd like to play
Sister? I started it in a TV serial with a wonderful professor, but we never
They're not convinced, they're smiling. You see, every time you say something, they start smiling, not convinced about what you're saying.
I will tell you her attitude. That one I can't, you know,
You can't
condense.
Deal with her.
But this one, I can't condense it. This one turns around to me, then you're going to work again. I said,
oh my God, this is
She said, No, you're not. I said, yes, I am. I've decided on stories. Just 5 days. I can keep. She said, you're working. I said, I can do that too. So she said, well, what about money? I said, well, you know, it's very good. This is how much they pay me. So she said, no, they're not. I said, yes, they are. She says, you know, they don't even give me that much. I said, but I just signed the contract and took the signing amount. This is.
Madam. So somewhere deep down inside.
I said, we're not competing. I'm mummy. I'm all in different roles.
Let's end on that note. Is there healthy competition in the family?
There's no competition.
There's no competition?
If you're working together, we're always fighting about something or the other.
Have you all done a film, all three of you?
Yes.
Yes.
And what was it like?
I can't remember.
We
weren't
really together in the
film
recording Moonax. You and Riya had many scenes together.
No. My mother and me had a couple of scenes together.
Are you intensely competitive?
No, not at all. We get on each other's nerves.
Because I sense every time you've come up with something, they look at each other almost saying, there she goes again.
No, that's because she's like Dory in the movie Finding Nemo.
Yes,
so she says something, but then you ask the same question, maybe tomorrow she'll have a different answer. And that's why we have this look.
She can't remember anyone.
You're bipolar.
I'm going on to Alzheimer's. I cannot remember.
No, that's fair. But it's been wonderful talking to all three of you.
Thank you.
And as I said, I'm blessed to be in the presence of Bengali cinematic royalty.
Thank you. You made it very easy. Thank you.
That's it on India Today, India Tomorrow with the three gorgeous Sens. Thanks for watching.
Thanks for watching the video. For more such news and updates, please like, share and subscribe to India Today. Also check out our other great videos from our channel. We know you will love to.